All right, I thank you, Vince McMahon. Let's bring you up to date this progress report in the World Wrestling Federation surrounding recent activities. In the great wrestling city of Phoenix, Arizona, Mr. T, yes, Mr. T, met boxing Bob Orton in an actual boxing match. I did have the opportunity to spend time with this distinguished athlete, Mr. T, in the gym as he worked out in preparation for the match with Bob Orton. Let's take a look. All right, the man pulverizing this water bag right now will be making his long-awaited return to center ring on tonight's main event, Mr. T. Mr. T, if I could have your attention. T.
What you want, fool? Don't you say I'm trying to work out, trying to get ready? You don't come interviewing anybody when they're working out. Now get that microphone out of my face.
Now, wait a minute, Al. I was just trying to explain to our audience that you're going to be putting on the gloves tonight against battling Bob Orton, Cowboy Bob Orton. Mr. T, please.
Let me tell you something. This ain't gonna be no fight. This is gonna be a war. I'm a smash the chump. When I get finished with him, he's gonna look like you. Now get out of here. You heard what I said?
In Phoenix, Arizona, Mr. T, this man, met cowboy or boxing Bob Orton in an actual boxing match in front of a capacity crowd here in the World Wrestling Federation. Mr. T, with an amateur background as a boxer, and Bob Orton, the big veteran from Kansas City, Missouri. All of a sudden, from out of nowhere, Rowdy Roddy Piper, as usual, this very controversial man, arrives on the scene, and this particular match culminates when Rowdy Roddy Piper takes the whip to Mr. T. Now, on his way back to the locker room, I cornered Mr. T after he had taken that brutal whipping at the hands of Rowdy Roddy Piper, along with the assist, if you will, of ace or battling or boxing Bob Orton. And Mr. T, at that point in time, openly challenged Rowdy Roddy Piper to a boxing match. He wants this man in a big, big way. Mr. T, on a national television broadcast of Saturday night's main event, demanded that he have Rowdy Roddy Piper. In addition, on the main event, Hulk Hogan had a title defense against the Magnificent Morocco. On this particular evening, things did not go well at all for the heavyweight champion of the world. Hulk Hogan in the ring, for the most part, dominating his match, as you can see with Don Morocco. Morocco's manager, Mr. Fuji, was sick. He was replaced by Bobby Heenan, who manages King Kong Bundy. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, King Kong Bundy, yet a third party, enters the ring and avalanches and repeatedly, along with Don Morocco, body splashes the heavyweight champion of the world, Hulk Hogan. I've got to believe in my own mind, Bobby the Brain Heenan masterminded this entire incident. A shocked, a stunned capacity crowd at the Veterans Memorial Coliseum in Phoenix, Arizona, could not believe what they had just seen. The brutal beating of their heavyweight champion of the world, Hulk Hogan, by Bobby Heenan, King Kong Bundy, and of course, the Magnificent Morocco. That capacity crowd saw others come to the assist of the heavyweight champion. The attending physician, Dr. Robert Ponovich, taking the stretcher and the heavyweight champion back to an awaiting ambulance en route to the hospital. No question, the heavyweight champion was hurt, and hurt quite seriously. As you can see, being put into the ambulance, also on hand, Gorilla Monsoon, Mr. T arriving at the hospital with tremendous concern for Hulk Hogan's fate. And of course, we talked with the doctor regarding the condition of Hulk Hogan. The heavyweight champion of the world was released the following morning from Good Samaritan Hospital. We did get a status report from Dr. Robert Ponovich. Let's listen.
First of all, he sustained a cerebral or brain concussion. We watched him over the night, and his status did not deteriorate. He also received multiple injuries of his low back or lumbar spine, his ribs, and his cervical spine.